So as you can see, I'm doing something different. But first, welcome to this installment of Tainted Eats with me, Lawrence Gilliard Jr. Okay, we have a special episode. I'm so excited because we're having my very first special guest chef who agreed to do this. Her name is Caroline Cerqueda, better known as Chef KC up here in the Hamptons, where she's a celebrity chef to the celebrities. You hear the laugh here? Come on in here.
Hi, everyone. Hi.
We're going to be making some special stuff today. It's all healthy. So come back in. Chef KC is a holistic chef. She's also certified holistic nutritionist. Tell us what it means to be a holistic chef.
Well, holistic chef is someone that works with a lot of patients that have dietary restrictions. So we wanted to heal through food. So my specialty is working with clients that have nutritional issues, mm-hmm. for the most part, yes.
So we're going all healthy today, and that's why we're in the park.
Yeah.
That's why we're out here in the park, and we're not in my kitchen this time, all right? So we're gonna get right to what we're gonna make, which is some energy balls. We're gonna make some energy balls, and then we're gonna do a special open-faced peanut butter and jelly sandwich.
Yum.
So yummy. All right, see you guys in a minute. And Chef KC isn't hanging out with me in the park. She's whipping up delicious, healthy dishes for her celebrity clients in the Hamptons, New York, and Palm Beach, Florida. Go and follow her page right now on Instagram at KC Healthy Ways. Before heading into the park, we made a pit stop at Chef KC's favorite natural foods market, Provisions. It's a really charming store with loads of natural, healthy options. After a few trips up and down the aisles, we finally had all the ingredients that we needed for our energy balls.
All right.
Good?
Yes, good. We all set to go.
All set to go?
All set to go.
So, before we go any farther, I have to give a shout out to my very first sponsor, Fresh Factor Juice. Yes, indeed. Fresh Factor Juice. And it makes sense because, you know, we're going all healthy, like I said. And they have all the good, yummy health packed right into here. This one is the top of the morning. As you guys remember, I had that one on the last episode. Top of the morning. It has apple, ginger, carrot, orange, and pineapple. It's 100% natural. There is no added sugar. There's no preservatives. Cold pressed and delicious. Fresh Factor Juice. Thank you. All right, let's get back to the food. As Chef KC unpacked the ingredients, we had no idea what Mercury in retrograde had in store for us. So these are the ingredients for our energy balls. We have some flax seed, some unsweetened coconut, chocolate chips, yay. We got chia seed over there. We got some vanilla. We need some peanut butter, some honey, and some oats. That's it. That's all we need. Let's get to it.
You may not, I will.
Mm-hmm.
Do you want me to talk right now?
No.
I'm just separating everything, like making sure we have all of that stuff. We have a little bit of our healthy peanut butter here, like no palm oil. Palm oil is not good for you at all. So I tried to get this peanut butter that doesn't have any palm oil.
Healthy peanut butter.
Healthy peanut butter.
All healthy. We're going all healthy. So,
half a cup of peanut butter. We already did 1 cup of oats. 2/3 of a cup of coconut, shredded coconut. I use unsweetened coconut because we are already using a little bit of chocolate, like semi-sweet chocolate. So you don't want it to be too sweet. You know, that's the main reason why we use unsweetened chocolate. And also you want to cut down on the calories. You don't want it to use things that are sweet on top of sweet. You don't want to add on calories. You want to make everything like taste delicious, but you want to be on the healthy side. So here there is half a cup of peanut butter. And we are going to use as well half a cup of flax seeds.
And then it happened. The very first thing that happened is we totally lost sound. I don't know how, but it happened. We didn't know, so we just kept going. So I'm just going to narrate this part of the video. I asked Chef Casey how much ingredients were in the dish. So she told me 1 cup of oats, 2/3 cup of shredded coconut, 1/2 cup of creamy peanut butter, 1/2 cup of ground flaxseed, 1/2 cup of chocolate chips, 1/3 cup of honey, 1 tablespoon of chia seeds, 1 teaspoon of vanilla extract, and then you just get your hands in there and you get to mixing. This is the part where Chef KC explained that as you're rolling your balls, things can get a little sticky, especially in between your fingers. So she recommended, if you have one, it's best to use an ice cream scoop. Then you can get the perfect amount of mixture so you can make the perfect size little round energy ball. This is the part where Chef KC was saying something really important, but I have no idea what it was. This is the part where I came around and joined Chef KC and said, okay, I'm gonna get my hands dirty right now, I'm going in. Which, as you can see, made Chef KC laugh. Then I started to make my own energy ball and say more charming and funny things because, you know, I'm funny and charming. And this is the part where Chef KC started to adjust the camera to just the right spot because, you know, teamwork makes the dream work. This is where I fought off a bee and Chef KC said, yeah, put it in the fridge. For about 2 hours. And then she said some other stuff, and she said some other stuff, and then it's ready to go. And this is my absolute favorite part of this whole video because I said something so charming and funny that it made Chef KC laugh out loud. And this is my second favorite part of the video because as I was rolling another energy ball and fighting off bees, yep, I've got skills, I actually did it again. Hey, what do you think, Chef KC? Should we take this show on the road? I think we should. And there you have it, beautifully rolled energy balls ready for the fridge. And finally, this happened. Honey being one of the main ingredients of the energy balls, it wasn't long before the bees started to attack and Chef Casey and I had run for our lives. And running from the bees made me think of this particular TV show that I was on. I think it's time for a story. Hey guys, all right, so we had to take a quick break because it is story time. Yes, time for the story. And of course, yeah, I made a trip all the way back to my kitchen just so I could tell you guys this story. So the story I'm telling today is the story of the real life bloodsuckers of TWD. Okay? All right. A few days after I was on the show, of course, you know, I ended up out in the woods. And one of the crew members comes over and starts spraying me with these chemicals. And I'm like, what are you spraying me with? And she goes, don't worry, you know, it's all natural. It's peppermint based and it's to protect you. And I'm like, protect me from what? And Steven Yeun, who played Glenn, who was one of the nicest, the funniest and most genuine guys on the show. He was great. Love that guy. He turns to me and he goes, yeah, Lawrence, you got to be careful, man. And then he proceeds to tell me how in the previous season, on 10 different occasions, he found 10 of these bloodsuckers on his body. 10. So I'm like, all right. And he goes, you know, you don't even know when they're on your body. You can't feel them biting you. You can't tell when they're sucking your blood. You don't find them until later at night when you're in the shower. Did you guys figure out what these bloodsuckers are yet? Ticks. Ticks, guys. Yes. In the previous season, on 10 different occasions, he found ticks on his body. So I'm like, well, I hope I don't find any of these ticks on me this season. Of course, a few weeks later, I think we're out. I think it was when we were doing, I think it was Bob, Sasha, Maggie out in the woods when everybody got separated. One of those days, you know, I finish working. I take off my Bob clothes. I put on my civilian clothes. I go back to my apartment. I jump in the shower. And I'm doing my scrub down thing, and then I feel this bump on my leg. And I'm like, what is this bump? You know, you feel any kind of bump or lump on your body, you freak out. I'm like, what is this bump? And to make matters worse, because this is a cooking show, I'll just say the bump was right next to the potatoes or the Franken beans, if you know what I mean. So I look down and dude, guys, there's a tick in my leg and most of it is in my skin. I just see the shiny back. So I reach down, I pinch real hard and I pop it out and the legs are still like, and I freak out. I squeeze in and I draw it down the drain and I turn on the hot water to flush it down the drain and burn it and boil it and scald it. And then I freak out, of course. I'm like, oh my God, I hope I don't like wake up and need to go to the emergency room or something. You know, who knows? I've never been bitten by a tick before. Anyway, that was the first time that I was bitten. It turned out in that first season, I was bitten by 3 ticks. Yes, 3 ticks. Luckily, I never had to go to the emergency room. But that is the story of the real life bloodsuckers on TWD. They got everybody at some point or another. So be careful in the woods, guys. All right, let's get back to the food. So when I tell you guys that the bees attacked, I mean the bees attacked. So I had to bring the whole operation indoors. I'm actually in a friend of mine's kitchen up here in the Hamptons. Unfortunately, Chef Casey could not hang with me. She was busy. She had to break out, go take care of some real business. So I am here holding it down on my own. So we're about to get into our open face PB&J, which was sent in by my homie, Holly Miller. And you can follow her at Eat Plants with Holly. That is Eat Plants with Holly. Such a healthy site. Go and follow her on Instagram. Go do it right now. You'll see a lot of amazing dishes. And she's the one who sent us this open face PB&J. Energy time. Let's do it. So here are the ingredients that we need for our open face PB&J sandwich. We need some peanut butter, all natural, organic, 100% peanut butter. Then I got the fig spread. It's 100% fig, no additives, no preservatives. I got Mother Nature's bananas. I got Mother Nature's strawberries, 100% strawberry. And I got some 21 whole grain seeds bread. I like to use Ezekiel bread, but I couldn't find Ezekiel, so I got this one. It's Dave's bread because, you know, it has only good stuff, all the good oats. And that's what we need for our open face PB&J. Let's get to it. This one's pretty easy, guys. Spread your peanut butter on all 4 slices of bread. Then spread your jam on your bread. Next, cut up some strawberries. Then, cut up some bananas. Arrange your strawberries in rows. Arrange your bananas in rows. And voila, you're done.
395,
396, 397, 398, 399, 400. Whew. There it is. Just knocked off 400 push-ups real quick. Because, you know, I don't know about you guys, but I always do my workouts in a button down short sleeve shirt with my glasses on. But anyway, you know what time it is after you work out. It's time to get a good, healthy energy snack. One thing you always need is some water. Yes. Good old nutritious Mother Nature. Water right there. The next thing you're gonna need I'm gonna get them out of the fridge right now because, you know, they've been in there for about 2 hours or so. We're gonna have some of Chef KC's healthy. See them right there? Check them out. That's right. Let's get one. Holy crap. That's good. It's sweet, it's yummy, and most importantly, it's healthy. That's right. All good, all healthy. Next, come over here. Check those out. You got to see them. Which one should we do? Strawberry or banana? Strawberry or banana? No, we'll do strawberry first. I'm greedy. Strawberry. Open face PB&J. Thank you, Holly. I'm gonna put some banana in there too. Hold on. I'm greedy. I used to eat banana peanut butter sandwiches when I was little, so that brings back a lot of memories. Okay, this was all about energy, pre-workout, post-workout energy. Make either one of these dishes and you'll have a great energy snack after your workout. Okay? All right, guys. I hope you enjoyed this one and I'll see you on the next episode of Tainted Eats. All right, guys. Bye. And good.